At one point in time, or at some point in time, it was a common thing for, you know, guys to hold the door open for girls, or, you know, pay for their dinner, stuff like that, open the car doors. But now it's becoming increasingly uncommon. I mean, it still goes on, it still happens, but it happens a lot less now.
Correct.
Do you think that's a good thing or a bad thing?
I definitely think it's a bad thing. I'm very traditional, so I like for men to open the door for me and be polite. And when they don't do things like that, you will be X'd off my list quickly. So I think it's all about how you're raised. I feel that parents are teaching men to do those things, and that's why they're basically not doing the whole chivalry thing anymore.
Why though? Why should men do that?
Because that's how you attract the right girl for you. If you don't have those values and you don't expect men to do things for you like that, then I feel that you might not get the type of person that will treat you good in life, you know?
So let me get it straight. Because of what you have or don't have between your legs, you should be treated special.
Not necessarily. I just feel that when men should go out of their way to show a woman that he's interested and that she is respected. And by you opening doors for me and going out of your way to show that you're a gentleman shows that you respect me. And if you don't respect a woman, you will treat her any kind of way, which is not opening up doors, not paying for the meal.
Any kind of way or equal? That's a difference between
them.
In other words, don't you think your point of view is sexist?
I think it's very Southern.
Because why is it on the men?
I think it's a Southern thing. I feel like down South, that's what women expect for men to do. Back in the day, I feel like it happened more often. But I think now in our generation, it's not as common because I guess we're just losing those values.
But you're saying it should be common, right?
It should be.
But how do you defend it as far as the sexism part? Don't you think it's sexist? In other words, if you were going if you were going looking for a job, okay, and you were doing an interview the same day as a guy, you wouldn't want the guy to be treated any special because he's a male, right?
Correct.
You want to be treated equal.
Correct.
So how can you pick and choose when to be treated equally? Isn't it an all or nothing thing?
See, with jobs, I feel that is different. I feel that when you're courting someone and you're looking for a mate, then you should do those things. Men are supposed to act a certain way. Women are supposed to act a certain way when it comes to dating. But as far as a job...
Because it's in your benefit, though. That's
yeah, but I feel
but
like...
But it's not in your benefit with the job case. So you're picking when to be you're picking when to be treated equal.
Not necessarily. I mean, I guess so. I guess... In my mind, that's how I was raised. So those are just the values that I have. And if it sounds sexist, then it sounds sexist to you. But to me, I feel that's how it should work. Most of my female friends look at it the same way. And most of them are from down South. And I feel that the girls that didn't think that way, they were from up North, you know? So I guess it's more of an old school type of way of thinking. And that's just how my parents are. And that's how they raised me. And I don't think it's nothing wrong with thinking that way. And when I raise my children, I will teach them the same values. I will not change the way that I think no matter what. And until I find someone that believes the same things that I believe, I will stay single.
Oh, you haven't found somebody yet?
No.
That's a whole nother interview right there.
Yeah, that's that is.
Well, let me just throw this out there. And I know you're not going to like this, but maybe that's why you're still single, is because you expect to be treated special as opposed to being treated equal.
No, I call that what you're saying is lowering your standards.
No,
I believe is...
How is 50-50 lowering your standards? How is total equality lowering your standards?
Okay, 50-50, that's a whole nother thing. 50-50 is you pay for one day, I'll pay for the next day.
Or you pay for yourself and he pay for himself. Or you open your own car door and you open your own...
No.
See, well, that's total 50-50. How can you argue with that? It's
no,
total equality.
That, because that is what a man is supposed to do.
You sound like these old racists who are stuck in their ways. Oh, that's what I don't like black because I was raised that way. I'm not going to look at it anywhere any different. I don't care if I'm 100 years old. You got to open up your mind and understand that, you know, we don't live in those days anymore. It's a new generation. It's a whole new thing. You know, I mean, we held on to a lot of people in general have held on to a lot of beliefs over the years that were just ridiculous. But over time, as we get smarter, more intelligent, we let things go. You know, like the race thing, for example.
But look at the divorce rate. I feel like that correlates with how people think. You know, people don't value marriage as much anymore. And I feel that that way of Marcelli. Thinking is something that has happened over time because people put more... I feel like they put more effort into looking at marriage as a business, you know?
But how does that relate to treating somebody special because of their gender, though? Nothing. Has nothing to do with it. It sounded good.
I guess
you that. It sounded real good. But but it had nothing to do with what we talked about. All right. Well, thanks again. I appreciate it.
No problem.
All right. See ya. Have a good day.
Bye. You too.
Thanks again.
No problem.
Keep up the good fight.
Okay.